वेलकम बैक टू माई चैनल फ्रेंड्स, दिस साइज सोनिया हियर फ्रॉम ग्रोइंग क्राफ्ट एंड फाइनली आई एम एबल टू अपलोड दिस वीडियो. दिस हैज़ बीन एन इमोशनल वीडियो बिकॉज ऑनेस्टली आई डिड नॉट एक्सपेक्ट दैट आई विल बी डूइंग सो मेनी ब्लंडर्स इन वन वीडियो. नाउ टू स्टार्ट विद, आई हैव दिस प्लास्टिक पॉट विच आई हैव बीन यूजिंग इन माई लिटिल गार्डन, बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग एनी वर्क आई हैड टू एम्प्टी दिस एंड क्लीन इट रियली वेल सो दैट आई कैन वर्क ऑन इट. I am starting with the acrylic color paint. I just thought give it a try to use my acrylic paint directly on my plastic pot and see how it works out. I am not using any gesso or anything. It's just a plain plastic pot, cleaned really well. There is no dirt, no clay, no mud at all, and I'm having a good coat of acrylic paint in this. Now I'm using my paintbrush for this process and I just need to make sure that I have a good coverage everywhere and I apply a good coat of acrylic paint on my project. Now here I will be doing 2-3 layers of acrylic paint because my pot is black, it's a jet black, and I want my decoupage tissue to pop out really well, so that's the reason I am having a white color on my base. And as you can see, I'm actually struggling with having proper white color on my base. So that's the reason I will have to go for 2-3 coats of acrylic paint. Now I have already pre-cut my decoupage tissues. This was a floral theme decoupage napkin, so I have already cut it and now I'm just removing all the plies. So what I have done is, it was actually a bunch of flowers which was the design was there in the tissue, so I had to cut few of the flowers from here and there, and I have kept some of the bunches as it is so that I can have some bigger 2-3 bunches on some of the patches of the pot, and on the rest of the areas maybe I'll just have one flower or the single flower or the corners here and there. I'll stick the smaller ones. I was not really sure that how many I'll be using, so I have cut so many flowers, but not worry, I am already going to use this on some of the other projects, so that's not a problem. Now for sticking, I am using my Mod Podge, but before that, please make sure that your color has dried out really well. Now here the main thing starts, that the moment I started this video, there was so many distractions going on, and once I start my video, I do not like any distractions, but being a homemaker, I have to switch off my video many a times while making it. Like sometimes some visitors come, some courier comes, my house help calls me 100 times when I'm making my video, so that's a really big distraction. Secondly, I'm not giving any reasons, but somehow I really don't know why I was not able to do my decoupage work properly on the spot. I had so many wrinkles. Like here also you can see that I'm not able to stick it properly. Maybe I was too distracted, maybe I was somehow not able to focus on my work, and you can see that how I have so many wrinkles and bubbles out there. And trust me, in the decoupage, if you once get those wrinkles and bubbles, it's really difficult to remove that, and I hate removing that because I hate having those bubbles and wrinkles in my project. So this was a really big disappointment, but like I said, I don't like making just half the video and next day I'll do it. No, I don't like that. So that's the reason I did continue with this. I really don't know if it was a good decision or a bad decision. Maybe I could have waited for a day or two and then restarted this project. But I just kept on doing this video, and I was really disappointed with the way it has turned out. But I guess that's the best part of being a home artist, that you can enjoy your work, you can be with your kids all the time, you can do everything you want as per your convenience. So I guess we should also give that extra benefit of doubt for us. So no problem, here what I did was, I did the complete project, I did the sticking work, and It was a little disappointing, but yes, I did it. And at the end, I also tried to remove all the wrinkles and bubbles as much as I could. Now here, if you can see what I am doing is, I am just taking my bigger tissues first, and later on I am going to add the smaller ones because they are going to act as a filler for my project. So the bigger ones are going to take away the major chunk of the pot, which is actually a good idea. Yes, one more important thing that while making this, I realized just because the pot is curved, they are never the squares, they are in the round shape. So doing decoupage is a little tricky. So we should keep a little smallish size tissue so that it helps. Now again, this is completely my view, that I just felt that sticking the smaller ones were a little easier than the bigger chunk of decoupage napkins, because it's really complicated to work on a round surface. See, with the circular surface, with the squares, the rectangles, the flat surface, it's pretty easy to stick your papers on your project. So here I did all the sticking work. Here is one of the biggest disaster which I have done till date, and I'm feeling really bad that I could not do this because of so many distractions and nothing was planned. So now what I'm going to do is, I tried covering this up to finish it up with my sponge dauber, but even that was not working out. So I just thought, can you see these small wrinkles and bubbles? This has happened for the very first time and I'm really disappointed. So this has dried out, I think almost 60-70%. Now I'm going to give it a press with my dry paint brush. So this is not going to clear everything, but as you can see here, like if I just give it a press, this comes down. So I am going to do the same thing on all the areas wherever I'm seeing my bubbles, but I need to make sure that my decoupage tissue has not dried out completely, and I need to be really careful because at some portion the papers are coming out completely. I'm super disappointed, but of course I cannot waste this pot. So I am going to make sure that I press this and bring it to use. Now I'll just press it on all the sides. Now it's time to add my varnish to it. So here what I'm going to do is, I'm going to add some glitters. Now this is actually going to be my trick and tip to cover up all those faults in my project. So here I'm using my varnish, and here and there I'm going to use my glitter. Now this is completely optional. While making this, I realized that maybe I can just go for a first layer of varnish, and on the second layer of varnish I can add my glitters, so that it's easier for me to realize that where should I add more glitters and less. And this is not going to make any difference in how I'm having my glitter on my project. So with this, my pot is done and I'm super happy now. Yes, it was a roller coaster ride to make this video, but finally I could do it, and this is how I work. Trust me, when I'm working from home, I hardly get any chance to just sit silently for some time and plan out your work. It's really, really difficult, and especially being a mom of 7-8 year old kids, so it becomes really, really difficult. But
I enjoy my life, I enjoy my work, I enjoy my motherhood, and I enjoy doing so many videos. And thank you so much to all the people out there, those who are watching this video, to inspire me, to motivate me, leaving your such lovely comments, appreciating my work, liking my work, sharing my work. This one is for you, and thank you so much. Thank you. Bye-bye.